Hello viewers, welcome to Newsweek South Asia, a show where we will provide you fresh insights into South Asia's geopolitical, strategic and security situation. Let's begin the show with the headlines first. Four Indian Army soldiers killed in encounter with terrorists in Jammu and Kashmir's Doda. Pakistan's economic woes deepen as inflation soars in 2024, residents express frustration. And inflated electricity bills anger public as Pakistan-occupied Jammu Kashmir administration fails to honour agreement. Let's begin the show. A deadly encounter in Jammu and Kashmir's Doda district resulted in the loss of four brave Indian soldiers. This attack, carried out by Jaish-e-Mohammed-linked Kashmir Tigers, underscores Pakistan's persistent attempts to destabilize the region through terrorism. Despite India's ongoing efforts to maintain peace, the threat from Pakistan-supported terrorist activities continues to challenge stability in Jammu and Kashmir. Our report will tell you more.
On July 15th, a fierce confrontation erupted between Indian security forces and terrorists in the Doda district of southern Jammu and Kashmir. This skirmish was triggered by intelligence reports indicating the presence of terrorists in the area. Acting swiftly, the security forces launched a cordon and search operation. As the joint search party neared the suspected location, the hiding terrorists opened fire indiscriminately. Tragically, four Indian Army soldiers, including an officer, were injured in the firefight. Despite being rushed to a nearby hospital, all four soldiers succumbed to their injuries.
The search party was able to establish contact with the terrorist hiding in the area, which is a thickly forested and mountainous area with restricted visibility due to low clouds and rain. In the initial volley of fire, four Indian Army personnel were injured, who later succumbed to their injuries. Additional troops and equipment have been inducted to flush out the terrorist, and use of drones and other technical resources is being ensured.
The terror group Kashmir Tigers, linked to Jaish-e-Mohammed, claimed responsibility for the attack. The region has faced persistent security challenges due to ongoing infiltration attempts by terrorists crossing the line of control from Pakistan-occupied territory. Pakistan provides training and funding to these terrorists to infiltrate Jammu and Kashmir and launch attacks on security forces and civilians. The rugged and mountainous terrain offers these infiltrators opportunities to evade Indian security forces and carry out their missions. Pakistan's support for terrorist groups in Jammu and Kashmir is a part of a broader strategy of proxy warfare to exert pressure on India. Security experts believe that these recent attacks are orchestrated by Pakistan to undermine India and counter its claims of peace and stability in the region.
After the abrogation of Article 370, Pakistan has become very insecure about Jammu and Kashmir. So terror activities are being flushed into Jammu and Kashmir. So, and there is this Jaish-e-Mohammed, one of the cadres of Jaish-e-Mohammed, known as the Kashmir Tigers, who are claiming the responsibility. These terrorists are coming into the territory and committing terror activities. In this Doda area, this area is full of jungles, and here in this area, on specific information, there was this cordon and search operation which was done, in which this encounter has broken out.
Meanwhile, security forces successfully thwarted an infiltration attempt along the line of control in the Kirin sector of Kupwara in Jammu and Kashmir by eliminating two terrorists. The anti-infiltration operations are still ongoing. Earlier, two Indian Army soldiers were injured in an encounter with terrorists in the Kastigarh area of Doda district in Jammu and Kashmir. The Jammu and Kashmir police have launched a major crackdown on the terror network following the deadly encounter in Doda. Notably, terrorist tactics have shifted towards targeting the Jammu region instead of the traditional focus on Kashmir. Jammu is witnessing a disturbing surge in terror attacks orchestrated by Pakistan-backed groups, highlighting Islamabad's relentless drive to destabilize the region. Since 2021, the region has seen an increase in violence. Media reports indicate that the death toll of security forces in the Jammu region between 2021 and 2024 has risen to 51, including the recent killings in Doda. In response to these attacks, a large-scale search operation is underway with senior police and army officers personally overseeing the efforts. These terror attacks in Jammu and Kashmir underscore that the battle against terrorism is far from over. Despite India's best efforts, peace in Jammu and Kashmir remains fragile, largely due to Pakistan's continued patronage and promotion of terrorism in the region. Pakistan remains a central hub for anti-India forces, nurturing terrorism through its ISI and supporting groups like Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed.
Moving on, a series of powerful explosions shook the entrance of Bannu cantonment in Pakistan's Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, followed by a barrage of gunfire. The attack, executed with an explosives-laden vehicle and suicide bombers, breached the military facility's defences. Over recent months, the country has suffered the loss of numerous lives as terror groups relentlessly target both police personnel and civilians. The recurring assaults highlight the country's apparent inability to effectively counter the menace, leading to significant losses in terms of life and property. We have a report.
On July 15th, Islamist terrorists launched a deadly attack on a military base in northwestern Pakistan. A suicide bomber detonated an explosives-laden vehicle near the outer wall of a military facility in Bannu city, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, followed by insurgents opening fire. The attack resulted in the deaths of at least 8 Pakistani soldiers and caused significant damage to nearby houses.
जब सुबह नमाज के लिए हम उठे, फिर धमाके की आवाजें सुनी। ये पता नहीं लगा क्या हो रहा है। जब हम शहर आ गए और देख लिया कि ये केन में फायरिंग भी हो रहे, धमाके की आवाजें भी आ रही है, धुआं भी हम देख रहे हैं। और उन धमाके से कारोबारी लोगों का जितना नुकसान हुआ है वो काफ़ी ज़्यादा है, क्योंकि जिस दुकान के शीशे इमारत है ये काफ़ी सामान टूट गया हुआ है, ख़राब हुआ है कि वो दोबारा नया लगाना पड़ेगा, और ये कारोबारी दुकानदारों का ये काफ़ी नुकसान है।
The terrorists targeted the base in Bannu, which lies near the tribal area of North Waziristan, a known hotbed of Islamist militancy close to the Afghanistan border. This province has seen a surge in militant attacks in recent years. In January 2023, a suicide bomber disguised as a policeman killed at least 101 people, mostly police officers, in a mosque in the northwestern city of Peshawar. The militant group Jaish Fursani Muhammad, a faction of the Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan, led by Hafiz Gul Bahadur, claimed responsibility for the Bannu attack. The TTP, also known as the Pakistani Taliban, is a separate entity but loosely affiliated with the Afghan Taliban. Since the Afghan Taliban's takeover of Afghanistan in 2021, TTP has intensified its attacks on Pakistani security forces.
Late in 2020, when Taliban took over Kabul, everybody was thinking that what a great victory that this has been for Pakistan, that they have fooled the United States, all the while supporting the Taliban. And a lot of people thought that this was a masterstroke by Afghanistan, by Pakistan, that they now have an ally to their west, which is completely under their control. That was an overstatement even then, and it has turned out to be a complete lie now. What they have got on their western front is not an ally, but an autonomous body, an autonomous movement on its own, which will do what it wants to do, and it will basically keep on pushing Pakhtun nationalism wherever it finds. So that's what has happened.
In 2021, Pakistan supported the Taliban's takeover of Kabul, urging the global community to work with the Taliban and provide aid. Pakistan stood alone in backing the Taliban's return to power in Afghanistan. However, Pakistan's stance shifted as it sought the Taliban's assistance in combating the Tehrik-e-Taliban Pakistan. The TTP, sharing ideological alignment with the Taliban, aims to establish an Islamic caliphate by overthrowing the current regime. Pakistan hoped the Taliban would control the TTP, but the reality on the ground has been different. Despite Islamabad's expectations, a United Nations report revealed that the Taliban are generally sympathetic to TTP aims. Besides supplying weapons and equipment, Taliban rank and file, Al-Qaeda Corps and AQIS fighters assisted TTP forces in cross-border attacks. Afghanistan under the Taliban continues to be a breeding ground for terrorists, and Pakistan too bears responsibility for the growing terrorism in the region. Islamabad cannot solely blame the Taliban rulers for promoting and sponsoring terror organizations like TTP, as it is also accountable for the escalating terrorist activities that pose a significant security challenge in the region.
In Pakistan, 2024 has continued the economic turmoil of 2023. As inflation soars and the government struggles to address mounting financial pressures. Despite stringent measures imposed by the IMF, including increased taxes and currency devaluation, the government's failure to effectively manage these policies have left citizens grappling with skyrocketing prices and a deepening economic crisis. As essentials become unaffordable and the tax burden grows heavier, ordinary Pakistanis bear the brunt of a fluttering economy and ineffective governance. Arpot.
2023 was a tumultuous year for Pakistan. Mass protests, political instability, terrorism, economic crisis, the country saw it all. This year is no different than the previous year, as the nation finds itself entrenched in an economic quagmire while grappling with a surge in militant activity, deepening concerns about its stability following the February 8 general elections. Pakistan's economic crisis continues to worsen as the country struggles to cope with mounting debt, global inflation, and a sustained drop in GDP growth. The impact of this economic strain is deeply felt by the populace, with essentials becoming increasingly unaffordable for many. Pakistan's residents are grappling with the harsh realities of skyrocketing inflation and hefty tax duties, which are placing immense financial strain on daily life. Essential goods like food, electricity and gas have become prohibitively expensive, pushing ordinary salaried individuals to the brink of financial instability.
महंगाई जो है वो इंसान को इस वक्त जीने नहीं दे रही है. इंसान की जो ज़रूरत है, बिजली, पानी, गैस और अशिया खुर्दनोश, वो इंसान की सैलरी पर्सन की ख़ास तौर पे दस्तर से बाहर हो गई है. अब ये अगर ज़रूरी घर में बिजली नहीं होगी, खाने पीने की अशिया नहीं होंगी, वक्त पे तनख्वाहें नहीं होंगी, हर चीज़ में इंसान जो है वो तनख्वाहदार तबका जो है वो बुरी तरह से पिस रहा है. और इसकी वजह जो है वो हुकूमत की, इदारों की नाअहली है.
Compounding these challenges is the weighty tax burden imposed by the government. Increased tax on a wide range of goods and services have further strained the budgets of ordinary citizens. Many criticize the government's inefficiency in managing these economic pressures. Despite policies aimed at stabilizing the economy, the anticipated relief has failed to materialize, leaving the public to bear the brunt of these shortcomings.
कोई ऐसी अशिया नहीं है जिस पर टैक्स ना हो. आप घर के इस्तेमाल की दालें ले लें, चावल ले लें, आटा ले लें, इवन के जो वॉशरूम में इस्तेमाल होने वाली चीज़ें जिसमें साबुन है, उसमें भी हम 3 से 5 रुपये एक साबुन के पीछे टैक्स दे रहे हैं. शैम्पू है, सर्फ है, कोई ऐसी चीज़ नहीं है जिस पर टैक्स ना हो. बिजली का बिल है, उसमें टैक्सेस हैं, एक्स्ट्रा टैक्सेस हैं. गैस का बिल है, उसमें टैक्सेस हैं. हर चीज़ पर टैक्स है, लेकिन रिलीफ कहीं पर भी नहीं है. ये हुकूमत वक्त की नाअहली है.
In June 2024, Pakistan's inflation rate surged to 12.6%, up from 11.8% in May 2024, reversing a downward trend observed over the previous 5 months. This rise coincides with the conditions imposed by the International Monetary Fund as part of its financial aid program. These conditions require Pakistan to cut government spending, remove subsidies, increase taxes, and devalue the currency. While these measures aim to stabilize the economy, reduce debt, and foster long-term growth, they have resulted in immediate challenges such as soaring inflation rates.
Residents of Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir are outraged over inflated electricity bills, which they are expected to pay despite enduring severe load shedding. Shaukat Nawaz Mir, a local leader from the Jammu-Kashmir Joint Awami Action Committee, expressed the public's concerns and outlined the conditions agreed upon with the administration. Mir stressed that if the administration does not honor these commitments, residents will refuse to pay the bills. Here's our report.
In Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir, residents are grappling with severe overbilling for electricity, leading to widespread frustration and protests. The inflated electricity bills have become a significant burden on the people, who are already struggling with economic hardships. Recently, in a public address, Shaukat Nawaz Mir, a local leader from the Jammu Kashmir Joint Awami Action Committee, voiced his concerns regarding this issue.
जितने भी हमारे साबका बिलात हैं, जो घरेलू बिलात हैं, उनको जो है वो पेंडिंग रखा जाएगा. उनको, क्योंकि हमारा मुतालबा था कि तमाम सबका बिलाग को खत्म किया जाए, लेकिन हुकूमत की तरफ से कहा गया कि क्योंकि बहुत बड़ा रेवेन्यू का लॉस है, लिहाजा आप बिल जमा करवाएं. ताहम इस बात पे हमारा आपस में फैसला हो गया था कि जो सबका हमारे कमर्शियल बिलात हैं, मेरी मुराद दुकानों के या और अदारों के जो बिलात थे जो कमर्शियल हैं, उनका जो है तमाम सरचार्ज खत्म किया जाएगा. तमाम जो उसके फ्यूल एडजस्टमेंट चार्जेस जो हाईकोर्ट ने भी खत्म कर दिए हैं, उनको खत्म करते हुए जो बाकी रकम बचेगी वो 24 जो है माना किस्तों में जो जमा कराएगा हर साल.
There have been several protests in the past where residents took to the streets in various parts of POJK demanding a resolution to the overbilling crisis. Protests erupted in major cities and towns, with demonstrators calling for transparency and fairness in the billing process. There were instances when agitated residents set their electricity bills ablaze or tore them up and threw them into the Jhelum River. However, residents later reached an agreement with the administration to pay the pending bills under certain conditions. Mir clarified the situation further in a public message, emphasizing the terms of the agreement reached with the government. He reiterated that residents will not pay the bills if the administration fails to uphold its commitment.
इसी तरह जो हमारे डोमेस्टिक बिलात हैं, घरेलू बिलात, उनके वाले से ये बात तय हो चुकी थी हमारी कि उन सबका बिलात को नए टैरिफ से, जो नया टैरिफ जारी होगा, उसके मुताबिक कैलकुलेट किया जाएगा और उसके बाद उनको जो है जमा कराया जाएगा। तो आज जो एक नोटिफिकेशन सामने आया है जिसमें एक गोल मोल बात की गई है जी 12 के साथ में जमा कराया जाएगा, उसकी तस्दीक करने के लिए हम हुकूमत वक्त से और अदारों को ये बात बताना चाहते हैं कि चीफ सेक्रेटरी ने हमारे साथ जो कमिटमेंट किया है, जो एक वर्बल नुमाइंदा है, हमारा एक वायदा है, क्योंकि उस वक्त इंटरनेट की सर्विस बंद थी और हमारे फोन के ऊपर ये मुजाकरात हो रहे थे और उन्हीं मुजाकरात के नतीजे में एक टैरिफ जो है वो सामने आया और आज उसी टैरिफ का 13.5 का हवाला देते हुए ये नोटिफिकेशन जारी हुआ है। लिहाजा उस नोटिफिकेशन के साथ हमारी वर्बल जो कमिटमेंट है वो मैंने सोशल मीडिया के जरिए आपको, आवाम को और हुकूमत को बता दिया, अदारों को बता दिया और हमने सोशल मीडिया पर अपना जो है ऑफिशियल पेज के ऊपर जो है जम्मू कश्मीर ज्वाइंट अवामी एक्शन कमेटी का बयानिया भी मुश्तर कर दिया है कि अगर हमारे जो ये सबका बिलात है उनको प्रॉपर कमिटमेंट के मुताबिक सेटल नहीं किया जाता तो हम
The inflated electricity bills have been a boiling point for residents in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir for nearly a year. The administration's U-turn on its verbal commitment could escalate public anger and frustration. In such a scenario, there is a possibility of even larger protests occurring across the illegally occupied territory in the coming days.
And with that, we come to the end of this edition of Newsweek South Asia. We'll be back next week with more news, views and analysis from the subcontinent. Meanwhile, do keep writing to us at nwsa@anin.com. This is Shivangi Mishra signing off on behalf of the entire production team of Newsweek South Asia. Goodbye and take care.